The beautiful picture animation you will learn to create today looks like this. On a click, we showcase the first picture and the corresponding explanation. Then the second picture is shown. Then the third picture and explanation, the fourth and the fifth one. Though it looks quite complicated, this animated graphic is quite easy to create. So let us learn how to create this graphic from scratch. I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We share creative PowerPoint ideas to help professionals like you create engaging presentations. Here I am on a new slide. The first thing I'm going to do is to insert a square-shaped picture placeholder. For that, I need to go to Auto Shapes Gallery, pick up this rectangle tool, hold the shift button down, and let us draw a square like so. Then let us insert a picture. Let us go to Insert Pictures Stock Images, and I'm going to search for the image of a bird. Let me hit enter, and we have quite a few options available for us. Let me select this peacock, and I'm going to say insert. Now we need to crop this image in 1:1 dimension, so it becomes a square. So let us select this picture, go to picture format, go to crop, click on the drop down menu, go to aspect ratio, and choose 1:1. Now that is good. Let me hit escape. Now we have selected this, right click and cut this. Now let us fill that image which we cut onto this shape. So I'm going to right click on this shape, go to format shape, and here I have the fill option. Let me go to picture or texture fill. The picture source is clipboard. Since I already cut the picture, it'll be there in the clipboard. So when I click on clipboard, you can see that the image fills the square. Now you might wonder why I filled a shape with picture instead of just sticking the picture directly. The reason is, once I create an animated template, I would be easily able to replace this picture with another picture and maintain the dimensions when I fill a shape with picture. Whereas if I just have a square shaped picture stuck, then if I replace picture, then the dimension of the new picture may not actually match the dimension of this original picture, and therefore you will have a distorted diagram. That is why we follow the same procedure to create all our templates. You will understand this better as we move forward in this tutorial. Now we have got our picture in place. Now let us add a subtitle text. For that, once again, I'm going to use the same rectangular shape. Let me draw a rectangular box. Make sure that the dimensions of this box match the dimensions of this picture. Now, when I click on this picture, go to picture format, I can see that it is 211, which is the width of this picture. Now, I need to ensure that this one has 211 in dimension. So let me go to shape format, you can see that it has got the exact dimension I want. Now, let me go to shape outline, say no outline. Now let me fill the shape with the same dark color we used in the background here, and I'm going to write subtitle text. Now I'm going to change the font type to something thicker, like say 2cent MT condensed extra bold, and I'm going to increase the size. Now that looks good. Now this rectangle is not very visible in this background. I'm going to use a rectangular tool, and I'm going to place a background of sorts here, which is in slightly lighter background like this. Go to shape outline, say no outline, right click and send this to back. Now you can see that this box is clearly visible. Now I'm going to create some space for me to write the text underneath. So let us go to home again, pick up the rectangle tool and draw a box to match the dimension of the square and this one. And let us see if the dimensions are proper. It is 211. Now I'm going to write some text here. I can increase the font size to something more readable, like say 20. If I want, I can change the alignment of the text from middle to top. For that, let me go to this option called Align Text. Let us go to top. Now I can write more text if needed. I'm going to change the fill color of this to a little more lighter gray like this, and then the font color to black so it is much easier for people to read. Now we are going to animate this prototype. First, let us select this one, go to animations, and let us open animation pane so you can follow what I'm going to do. Then let us have this picture fly in. So I'm going to use fly in animation. By default, it flies in from below and it has the duration of 0.5 seconds. Now to add a bit of drama, I'm going to add spin animation to it. So let us select the same object again. Go to Add Animation. Since we are adding a second animation to the same object, we need to use this option and not any of these options here. Let us go to Emphasis and say Spin Animation. Now I can always change the direction to counterclockwise instead of clockwise. Now that looks interesting. I'm going to change the duration to match the previous one, which is 0.5 seconds. And I'm going to say that it happens with previous. And we are going to see how this one looks by going to slideshow. It enters like this. Now that looks really nice. The next thing is to have this peek in. So I'm going to select this and add a peek in animation by going to these options here. I can see that there is no peek in animation that is available as part of these ready-made entrance animations. So let me go to this additional entrance effects. And here I have the option called peek in. And I'm going to say, okay, let us have this peek in from top. And this happens right after previous. Now after this, I want the audience to read the explanation corresponding to the picture and the subtitle text. So let us have this box wipe in. So let us go to wipe and say it wipes from top and this happens after previous. So you can see that there are four animations in total. The first two animations happen simultaneously, which is this one flies in while spinning. Right after that, we have the subtitle text peeking in and then this gets wiped out. So that is our first prototype. Now all I need to do is to make multiple copies of this and place them one next to the other. So let me select this whole thing, press Ctrl D to create a duplicate, and I'm going to place this right next to the previous one. Now I can hit Ctrl D again, again and again. Now we have our five elements shown as shown in the title. The next thing I'm going to do is to replace this picture with another picture of my liking. So let me first insert the picture onto the scene by going to Insert Pictures and Stock Images, and I'm going to search for another bird. So let us say bird and hit enter, and there are quite a few interesting options available for us. Let me choose one of them. Maybe this one looks nice and I'm going to say insert. The next step is to crop this in a square shape. So let us select this, go to crop and say aspect ratio 1:1. Now I can change the focus of what element is shown here by clicking and dragging this so that I can bring in this bird right in the center. That looks good. Let me hit escape and this selection is made. Right click, cut this so it is in the clipboard. Now I can right click on this image, go to format picture, fill. And here I can change picture or texture fill by going to the picture source as clipboard. Since I had cut the earlier image, it goes directly from the clipboard onto my template. Now you understand why I first created a shape and then filled it with picture. It makes replacing pictures extremely easy. So when I go to slideshow, the way the animation plays is like this. We have the first picture and the explanation shown, and then the second picture and the explanation, and the whole thing goes on. Showcasing pictures is part of any presentation. You can use showcasing of pictures to talk about four-step process like the way that we are showing just now. And you can use it to show a timeline like this. For example, you can see that this is the first event, then we show the second event like this, and then the third event. See how dramatically we are able to use the pictures to hold the audience's attention. Let us take another example. Here we have used four pictures to showcase the title. Let us see another example. Here we are showcasing four pictures and their explanation. This is usually the most common way in which you showcase pictures, and this is combined with this interesting hand animation as well. The last example is this beautiful showcase of four pictures and their explanation, and you can see that the audience cannot take their eyes off this beautiful animation. Good slides with creative animation always capture the attention of your audience no matter how distracted they are. If you don't have the time to create those kind of creative animations for yourself, you can always pick up an off-the-shelf solution like our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle version 2.0. This bundle has more than 4,200 premium PowerPoint templates that are fully animated, so you can just pick and stick them into your presentation deck and you'll be able to have a really captivating slide deck available for your presentation. The link to this product is available in the description box below the video. Click on the link and check out more details about this product. By the way, did you like this beautiful picture animation tutorial? If you did, then you will really love this other tutorial that we have created for you that showcases how you can use animation in a creative way. All you need to do is to click on the link and start watching the tutorial to improve your animation skills to the next level. So go ahead, click on the link and watch this video right now.